This is the one input to output PoE standard. Adding this PoE standard to the system, we can repeat the PoE for another 328 feet. The maximum distance from the output port to the edge device is 328 feet. There's two output ports. You can either connect two IP camera, two access points, or one IP camera, one access point. In this video, I would like to add the auto access point to one of the PoE ports and still maintain the connection for the IP camera. First, let's see what we have. This is the PoE switch. The PoE switch is connecting the router. This blue cable provides internet accessing. The yellow cable is connecting to the network video recorder. The camera is live now. Now let me bring another pool of the K5 Ethernet cable. First, I will need to remove the cable from the camera and connect this cable to the input port of the PoE standard. Once I connect in, you can see the indicators on, which means the PoE standard is working with the PoE switch already. Now let's pick the one of the output port and connect to the new cable and connect the end of the cable to the camera. Let's go back to check the indicator. Now the LAN port is flashing, which means the PoE standard is working with the camera. We still need the second port for the auto access point. This is the rubber. We block the second port. If you don't need the second port, you can use this rubber to block the second port. I still need one more short punch code to link the PoE standard to this access point. You can see the indicators on, which means the access point is working with the PoE standard already. Let's move back to the indicator. It will take a while. Now we see the LAN port start flashing. It's quite simple. The maximum distance between this camera and access point to the PoE standard is 328 feet. So you could have quite long distance from the PoE standard to the new IP device. There's one last thing. If we just want to repeat the network for non-PoE equipment, like this router, these two are the PoE equipment. It needs both power and data from the PoE standard. What if we need to work with this router? They're simply just non-PoE equipment. We simply attach this network device to one of the ports? Yes. The reason is because this PoE standard has the power handshaking. Just now, after we connect this cable to this PoE standard, even if we didn't connect any new equipment to the output port, we still can see the indicators on, which means this PoE standard already complete the power handshaking with the PoE switch. They already set up the network. So it's ready to work with either the PoE equipment or non-PoE equipment. All right, that's all for today's video. Thanks for watching.